Hey guys, I'm JD Ross, and today we're going to upgrade this 64GB Steam Deck to 512GB. After unboxing a brand new Steam Deck, you will notice that it will not turn on even after pressing the power button, and that is called battery storage mode, which is the ideal mode when upgrading a Steam Deck. So what we're going to do is put the Steam Deck back into battery storage mode. Simply hold volume up, and then press the power button once. Choose Setup Utility. Go to Power, Battery Storage Mode, and then press A, then Yes. And there we go, it will not turn on unless you plug it on the charger. And we're going to use the case in order to hold the Steam Deck while upgrading. And excuse me while I clean the back of the Steam Deck because of my oily hands. Next thing you'll need is a toolkit. You can use a mobile repair toolkit, but I'm going to be using the iFixit kit. For the backplate, I like using the number 0. And I'm going to use the lid as a screw holder. The screws on the middle part are actually shorter than the one on the corners, so make sure to separate them. While unscrewing, if you notice that your screwdriver kept slipping off the screw, you might need more pressure, just not too much pressure, or you're using the wrong size of screwdriver. And you have to make sure that you're using the right size of screwdriver in order to avoid stripping the screw. But if you somehow strip a screw, you can use a flathead, preferably something smaller than the screw, and then use that to dig into the screw and then turn it very slowly and carefully. Now we're going to remove the backplate, and this is actually the hardest part of this upgrade process. So don't mess this up, because if you do, you might end up denting the side of the backplate. To open it up, we're going to use something like this. You can also use spare guitar picks, but it's much better if your toolkit also includes this. Also, make sure to remove your micro SD card before removing the backplate, or you will snap it in half. What you want to do is put your finger here, and then push the pick on this side, and run it to the other side. If done right, you should not have any dents whatsoever on all sides. On this part, we're going to remove 3 screws. One here, and another here. You can use the same screwdriver tip, but I like using a double 0 for the screws on the inside. For the adhesive foil, I'm going to use tweezers to peel it up a bit, but you could also use your fingernails for this. And there's the third screw. Now we're going to remove the battery. Simply pull this pull tab to the right, very slowly and gently. It might be tight and hard to remove, but just be patient. And there we go. Now we're going to remove the 64GB eMMC drive. simply pull this thing out, because we're going to put this on our new NVMe drive. And we're going to be using Western Digital SN520. It's a cheap but decent NVMe drive that is compatible with the Steam Deck. So now we're going to insert this drive into this protective foil. If your drive won't fit at all, you can unwrap this foil and then wrap it around the drive. This drive though is as thin as the stock eMMC drive, so we can fit it by putting it through the back. And there we go. We're now going to install it into the M.2 slot. For the battery, simply push it down and align it, and then push it to the left. You can use your fingernail to push it even more. And now we're going to put the backplate back into its place. Now we're going to download the Steam Deck recovery image. The link will be in the description. While that's downloading, let's download Banana Etcher. Just click this download button. And then install it. After it's done, open Banana Etcher. Flash from file, and then find the Steam Deck recovery file. Select target and then target your USB drive. Select and then flash. This only appears when you have a really big USB drive, like a 512 gigabyte drive. So this might take a while depending on what kind of USB drive you used. I recommend using USB 3 instead of a USB 2 flash drive, so the process of flashing would not take too long. Back on the Steam Deck, as you see, the power button will not turn the Steam Deck on. We have to plug it on the charger, and then it will turn on, but it will not boot since we haven't installed SteamOS just yet. Here's the dongle that we're going to use so we could plug the flash drive that we just made into the Steam Deck. And then hold the Steam Deck power button to shut it down, and then plug the flash drive onto the Steam Deck. Hold volume down, and then press the power button once. And then press A. This might take a while, so just be patient. And on this part, sometimes you can use your trackpad and your triggers as a mouse. But if it doesn't work, you could just use your touchscreen and then tap Reimage Steam Deck only once. Do not double tap it. But if you still somehow double tapped it, do not press proceed on the same dialog twice. Just close the second one after pressing proceed on the first one. And then press proceed again. And your Steam Deck should now boot to SteamOS. Okay, on the setup, you will notice that your gamepad may not work. Don't panic, it's normal, it's probably a bug of the setup, but that's okay. We just have to update it. You could use the touchscreen to connect it to Wi-Fi and then install the update that will fix the controller. When you get to this part and it's been way too long before the installation even finishes, you can tap back and then do it again. And there we go. Now let's check if it's actually 512 gigabytes. There it is. Of course, it's not going to be 512 because SteamOS has to take some space, but it's not 64 gigabyte anymore. So that's it. I hope I helped you guys. If you have questions, just comment it down below. Thank you for watching and see you on the next video.